welcome back to Rach and Bella Craft.
Richard here. I hope you're all well.
So today I thought we'd get on with our altered book again, having lots of fun filling this up at the moment. And you'll recall if you watched yesterday's video, we made these little flip pockets that sit on this lovely piece of elastic. So today I wanted to have a go at doing Roxy's weekly challenge. She made these beautiful little trifolds. So I've had a go and I've done a dry one, a dry run even, put my teeth in, because I wanted something that was going to sit on the other side of this elastic. So if you remember, we put the elastic through the piece that was left in the journal, and I wanted something then that will sit on this side. So I have made one, but I'm not overly happy with the size, mainly because of the proportions of my journal. So what I thought we would do is have a go, but we would use some cardstock to make the cover, and then we'll do the inside then slightly differently as well. So let's have a little go at that. So if you haven't yet watched Roxy's weekly challenge, she makes these beautiful little trifolds. So obviously by try, it's just threefold there. And then inside they've got envelopes or further flip outs with pockets in, or in this case I had a go at making the accordion pocket that will fit inside of there. But like I say, I want to try and do one that's going to have larger proportions. So I thought obviously my papers are not going to get any bigger than they are, because, well, they are what they are. They're A4, aren't they? And this book clearly isn't. So I thought if we use a 12 by 12, it should give us a little bit more height, because the width obviously is fine. But if it does come in a bit more, even better. So I've got here this Stamperia pad. If you remember, I was gifted this by Mum a couple of weeks ago. And I've picked a page, which I think is going to go really nicely. Because obviously this is the bit that you're going to see on the outside, but I thought it goes really nice with this bit of lace on here. How fortuitous, some might say, because I had no idea I was going to do this yesterday, but I think they go really nicely, especially like that centre bit there. The colours are just, oh yes, very yummy. So the first thing I'm going to do is decide on how large I want my trifolds to be. So I'm just going to take this one out of the way a second. That was my prototype, because I thought I need to check this is going to work, because I just had this funny feeling. Now, this is a gorgeous piece of cardstock. I'll just remind you again, because I know you're all going to say, what were you using, Rach? It's this one here, Stamperia Old Lace. Love it. Gorgeous kit. I'm trying to use it sparingly, because once it's gone. I don't want to lose those flowers. I'm just thinking where I'm going to cut, because I want to make sure that we've got, you know, this. Perhaps I'll just chop the top then. And I'm thinking, of course, the thing is as well, it's got to fit between the, so although I want it to be larger, it still has to fit between this gap here. Look, it's got to go in the elastics. So let's get a tape measure. Let's just measure the elastics, and then we know what we are playing with, don't we? So, okay, so just by simply taking that away there and that away there, we now have the perfect length. This will now fit inside of here. She says it will fit. Just needs reminding me, boss. No, it does. See, that fit perfectly in there. So now I just have to do my folds, but hopefully then I should end up with slightly longer here. So I just need to be careful about the way in which I'm doing my folding, because obviously, like I say, I just didn't want something in there that was just going to sit too short inside of the page. And I just think that's lovely. It's going to be nice and sturdy. So to get with the folding, I know that Rachel was obviously folding her outer pieces first and then folding her inner pieces, but I think I might do mine the other way around, solely because of the style I'm going to be putting on the inside, because it really doesn't make an awful lot of difference to me. I do want that there on show, you see, because I think that is just lovely, and I think that'll be really nice on top of that page. So what I thought we'd do is grab my bits and pieces that are going on the inside. So what I thought we'd use is this page here. This is one of our freebies on our coffee page, if you wanted to go and use that. This is a backing page out of the spring kit, and this one is out of this current kit. And because I am making a, what's it called? A harmonica, accordion. It's not a harmonica, it's an accordion. Because I mean an accordion. Where did I get a harmonica from? I think that's what we call them in this country. Mouth organ, mouth harmonica. No, I'm just talking rubbish. Please don't repeat anything I just said. It's a load of nonsense. Because I'm making a accordion pocket, which is a, like a squeeze box, isn't it? I'm not going to be able to see what's down inside anyway. So the only thing I'm going to see is the bit that's on the top. So I've got to decide, first of all, which bit of the paper I want on show. Well, I want this bit on show, so I'm going to be folding this in half anyway. So you won't see the back of that. You're only going to see the top of this. Right, okay, so I've got this one here. I've taken the white bits off just because I was going to make a poo, so I did actually cut it, the one section off, because that's on the bottom, and then realised I made it too short. So, what I'm going to do is turn it that way, and then I just need to fold that around there, because even though this bit's going on top, I just need to make sure that the size is right, and just that spot on there. There we go. Let's take that away a minute. Right, there we are. So that will now fit, should now fit snugly on top of the snugly. That's a new word, sniggly. Now that would crease my son if I said that to him, because he always laughs when I say muggy. Muggy. So I get up most mornings, well I don't at the minute because it's too blinking cold. But I get up most mornings and say, oh it's muggy this morning. So he just wanders around the house going, muggy, 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 muggy. What a silly word, muggy. Now I notice how you don't notice that words are daft until somebody else starts saying them repeatedly, over and over and over again. I'm going to go out and say sniggly to him now and see what he says. I'm a terrible torment. Terrible torment. Right, there we go. So that is how it will end up looking. And then that will open up like that. And then I will glue down the side here. I will glue there. And I will glue down these sides here. So all you will see then, obviously, is the inside of there and the inside of, well, barely the inside of those two there. So I'm just going to go and trim now to just make sure that the top is the same there as it is with that. And then I just need to take a smidgen off there just to make sure that that's the right length. I'll be in 1 minute. Right, okay, so I have inked now all around my edges. I'm gonna stick this down now. So I'm gonna start off, well, I'm guaranteeing I get glue on there. Right, so I'm gonna start off by gluing here. Should be completely flush now, top and bottom of that. There we go. Marvellous. And then I'm going to glue here and here. To glue this edge here, And up this edge here. Sorry, I whispered that really quietly then. I get really like, gotta concentrate when I'm gluing. Little bits around the edge. Probably helps if I've got my reading glasses on. It's because I'm like not blinking so I can see. And then I can't talk because I'm not blinking. Here we are. Right. So that's that then. Yeah, that's settled it out. Let that dry. What I thought I would do then, because that's a bit annoying on there, so I thought I might take this, and just add that onto there, and it'll give the flap a little bit of weight and help it to stay down. That makes sense. I need to add a bit more ink on that. I did go around it, but it's not enough. It's better. Just because it's, you know, the flappy bit, and it needs to look like the flappy bit, doesn't it? There we are. Right. So what I thought I'd do is glue this on there. And then we can glue this then into here. Oh, and I need to obviously just score and fold that, don't I? Because I haven't done that yet. Because you know me, I like to do everything back to front. Right, let's just add a bit of glue here. Let me just plop that down there like that. And then squish it out. I'm sure it'll, like, you know. I'll add that bit there on there. That's the thing with stamp period. All of the scraps are lovely, aren't they? But I really want that bit there in there. Because there's a bit of lace and there's a bit of thingy-ma-jiggamy on there. Whatever thingy-ma-jiggamy means. Right, let's turn that over. Oh, that's nice. Lovely. Lovely jibbly. Right. Just make sure that is stuck into place. Bend that back there a minute because I just want to make sure it's thoroughly glued down. I don't want anything riding up there. Set, and then the same there. Make sure that's thoroughly glued down because obviously, being a flap of an envelope, they get there's a lot of movement goes on, isn't there? So you can make sure that's nice and secure. What did you miss, scissors? Let's just trim the edge. Again, not blinking and not breathing, so I can see. It's the trouble you get older. Look, you have to prioritise the things that you do, and that even includes bodily functions like breathing and blinking, because I can't do more than one thing at a time. Right. Okay, don't need to go glue ink in the back, so you won't see the back. Oh, I really like that. I really, really do. Now, I wonder if we might just pop that on there. No, I don't think that's going to go, is it? Because that is actually a black and white photograph, and we're kind of working with sepia there. I wonder if that might be okay. That might work. But I don't think we need to put a closure on the inside. So I'm not going to over egg it. That's going to cause bulk, otherwise, isn't it? Inside of our, you know what. Right, so this now needs to come up, and it kind of needs to be a little bit longer. Just a smidgen, I would say. So if I take that like there, maybe? Yeah, okay. Just wanted to make sure I got my length right first before we commit. Oh, there it is. My bone folder. Using the wrong one, I was. The other one's all right on the actual scorer. Probably help if I use a scoreboard, wouldn't it? I'm awfully lazy. I just can't be bothered to get it up off the floor because it's so big. Here we go. Right. So that's that bit there. Or maybe I will for this bit. Oh, I'm saying that's not where I thought it was. Oh, there it is. See, I'll teach you, Rach. Calling it names, and then you want it, then it's hiding from you. Where's it gone? The desk's getting a mess now. Sorry, that's a good sign. It means fun's being had. Right, there we are. Perfect. Oh, I like that there. Ho ho! See what I mean about the Stamperia card? This is always a little surprise. Did I say 1833 on there? I can't see. Does it? No, it doesn't. It says 1853. That's a shame. That would have been nice. We're watching that at the minute, 1833. It's really good, actually. like a western. Well, it's not actually a western, is it? It's, I don't really know what it is, but it's very good. It's very interesting. It's got me googling, and I love it when I'm watching something historical and then I'm googling it to see how, you know, you learn other things then, don't you? It's talking about, they were on about yesterday, the railroad. How they could have got the railway to, I think they're going to Oregon. Is that right? Up in the top left-hand corner. So I got my map out, so I was looking again. So, oh yeah, I forgot that was at the end. I mean, it was a big Texas was. Cool, massive state. And I'm walking across Texas. And then he said, oh, well, they get the train. And I thought, oh, that's interesting. Did they have trains running right the way across the states in 1883? So I was looking at that last night, and then I got distracted, as I do being a magpie. And then, so you're not going to learn anything interesting in a historical human freak, guys. Right, I'm really pleased with that. I like that. I think that looks lovely. But we need to stick this in. We need to add a closure. We need to add something in here. And then I want to put a pocket in there. So let's get it done. Let's get this finished. So are we happy with that? Yes. Happy with that? Happy with that? Yes. Ooh, that looks nice. Good. It's all looking good. Let me add some of my harmonica pockets. You know I'm going to call them harmonica pockets now, don't you? God, Rachel, I've come up with some rubbish, honestly. Rachel from Rock Secretions would be rolling her eyes, I'm sure. Thinking, what is she talking about? Harmonica? Nope. Right, it's an accordion. It's an accordion pocket. See, I know that now, though, and I won't forget it again. I probably will. Let's be honest, I probably will. I'm going to leave the top open because I think it might be a nice opportunity if you want to pop a tag in there. I forget about tags. I don't make tags very often, and I forget about them, so... I think that might be quite a nice little addition in there, if I'm being honest. And I'm going to butt that pretty close to there. Remember what I said about leaving that bit of a gap top and bottom? If you've done that, make sure you then, when you glue it in, ensure that that gap is even. Even Stevens. Yep, looking good. Yes, happy with that. Very nice. Okay, let's press it down. Oh, it is nice working with my art glitter glue again. I've forgotten what a professional tool it is. I was getting a bit of a mess with the other stuff. It's good, don't get me wrong. The mono is good. But when you're in a hurry and you're trying to go from, you know, step one, step two, step three, I haven't got all day to wait then for glue to dry. Well, I haven't got 10 minutes to wait for glue to dry. So to have that then go on, bind and be ready to move on is great. Just wish we could get hold of it easier, that's all. Oh, I'm loving this. This is very nice. I like this by itself. Never mind, pop it in there. Very nice indeed. Now, I need to pop something in here now. I'm going to put a pocket in, a tuck maybe. Or should we go for a pocket down here? No, I think a tuck in there, and I think we'll put a pocket on there. Sounds like a sheep saying that then. There. Oh, dear me. Honestly, I've had a bit of sunshine yesterday. Okay, so I wonder if we could put, do I put a bit of a pocket on there that's going to match? No, because this doesn't really, you know I'm bringing the brown in, but I am pushing that a bit, and I'm relying on the pink and the brown to kind of, so I think if I go over this, it would be better. We need to get rid of that green. It's jarring me a bit. It's a bit jarring, as my kids would say. Right, what am I looking for? I am looking for... Okay, so I have finally found what I'm looking for. I've got a piece like this that matches the piece that was on the back of this, because I thought that would kind of tie them in nicely. I didn't have a punch to make a lovely pretty stencil mark down there, so instead I've just used my deckle edge cutter just to give a little bit of, you know. And then this one is one of the pockets out of the kit. So I thought that would be ideal to just pop over the top of this bottom bit here, in keeping with the theme. So I just shut in those holes down there and just cut that little bit of thread off. So I've just gone round and done a little bit of stitching on them. I'm going to just glue that onto there now. And that will make a nice little pocket then, just to pop some bits and pieces in. Not too much, obviously, if you don't want to start making it bulky. Sorry, I've got itchy nose. Tell the pollen's up. My goodness, I had the sneezes this afternoon. Then it was an end. There we go. Oop. probably your pocket shirt, your harmonica pocket. Oh, look at me thinking I glued the darn thing shut. It's meant to be glued in the middle, isn't it? Duh! Right, and then this one. Now, I did contemplate putting a piece of lace here, but I just felt it was a bit flimsy. Sorry if I hiccups again. Because I was going to be opening and shutting, and I thought, oh, if there's lace the other side of that, I'm going to be catching my hands on it. So I'm going to just go with a matching bit of paper. Oops. Just pop a bit of glue there, a bit of glue there. Oh my goodness, a bit of glue there. And pop that down there like so. Trying to make as little amount of mess as possible. Now we've got pockets. So we've got, I love this. I want a puzzling on the front, but I really just don't want to cover this cover because it's just gorgeous. So I'm not going to, because I love it. So we've got that, then it comes down over the top. That then goes down over the top of there. Now I've got a little idea what I want to do then on the inside. We've got to put a closure on the front of here. So perhaps we'll do that next. And I just picked that up actually, which I think will go quite nicely on the front of there, and it pops out a little bit. Otherwise, I've just got like these round disc things, but they're all far too big. I don't have anything else to hand. No, I think I'm going to go with this. That'll do. It'll do nice. Let's not get double-minded, Rach. Stick it down now. Come on. Because the veggies are on, and your beeper will be going before long. Right, I'll let that dry. Come back to that in a minute. I need to put a, you know, thing in the front of there, and then we'll put a tie around. But inside here, what I thought we would do, I actually really like that as well, because I want to make like something here, and then add what we've got. I'm just trying to use up the tickets I've got on my desk, and I've also got more tickets here. So of course, bearing in mind now, this is obviously going into this altered book. The altered book is meant to be like a vintagey scrapbook, so obviously you can expect to see things like tickets, etc. Oh, do you know what? A blinking fly has been flying around my room all day. I thought I caught him earlier. So annoying. Right, okay. What about that there? And then that there. Maybe. I'm trying to bring the pink over, you see. We don't need all doom and gloom brown, do we? And then maybe that there. Oh, look at that. Looks like the front of the... Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Quick, glue it down before you forget. If that goes back on there in the same shape, I'll eat my hat. Is that what it looked like just now? I don't know. I can't tell from where I am. You were looking at it. What do you reckon? Looked like it had fallen over the front, didn't it? That'll do. That'll do. Cute. And then pop that one in. Stay still. Overlap, but you see, here we are, and then nice, we've got a word up there. But what I was thinking for this bit here was to do something like, because I'm thinking if I had like lots of little tiny little bits of ephemera, I'd want to do something pretty cool with them in my my journal. So what if we make a little like collage-y thing at the side here on the flappy bit? That's already inked. I did have that stamp. That's the one I want. I love this stamp. This is out of the spring kit. Do you know what? I don't think I've ever seen a hyacinth shader out so much as I have from this spring with that kit. It was lovely. It's all over our Facebook page. Fair dues to you guys. You really got on board with that kit, didn't you? And I'm thinking I might bring that bit of blue over as well. So at the end of the day, ephemera is ephemera, isn't it? You're keeping your favourite bits and pieces. You're not, you know, judging them on colour or anything here. And then we've got a little flag here. I might utilise that as well. So, being inspired by Shaver's snippet the other day, we're going to try and attempt to do a little bit of a snippet of our own, but on this thing here. So, let me just cut a couple more tickets up, because I don't tend to cut them all out immediately, because they go missing. Not that they go missing because I cut them out. Well, they probably do go missing because I cut them out, because it's easier to lose a tiny bit of paper than it is a large one that's still, you know, together, so to speak. Right, so what I thought we'd do is this. So let's just try and make some sense of all this now. Right, so start with the big one at the bottom. Maybe we'll pop that in the middle and we'll kind of work out from there. What I thought we could do was kind of something like that. You stay there a minute. Oh, where's my... Come here, I need a hand. Oh, freak everybody out now, because they all hate this hand. Yes, I got my own thing, look. My very own thing to help me out. Right, there we go. Right. So, do you see what I'm trying to... Like, you know, obviously I'll have to, actually this one I need to hold there, hold that one too, thanks. As long as it doesn't start tapping now, we'll be all right, won't we? Oh my gosh, that would freak me up my skin. Right. So I'm thinking like there, I'm thinking that's upside down. No, it's not. No, it's not. Perhaps not have those two pinks together, but do you see where I'm going with this? So I think it's best if I like stick them down as I go along, because otherwise they're going to be moving all over the place. But I just thought that would look quite cool, and then we kind of snip it over the top. I'm just going to start sticking. I don't think it needs to have rhyme or reason. I think we need to start from here out. So let's plonk that down. I'm just going to glue in the middle for now, and then if I need to tuck something under it or over it, I can. Let's go with pink next. Ooh, don't fail me now, glue. And we'll have a bit of green. Obviously, watch doesn't go over, because you've got to open it out, in and out. But I just think it'd be a bit of fun. Obviously, you can do this with anything. You do it with fabrics if you want to. I think I probably add a little snippet of lace on this now just to tie it all in. And I might even add my little ruffle bits. Well, then again, maybe not, they're the wrong colour. But oh, can you believe I did that yesterday? That was so frustrating. Right, there we go. Just tuck that under there. And then let's add that one on top of there. Ooh, hands are shaking. This is not a good time for shaky hands. I panicked then because I realised I'd stuck that ticket all the way down. I didn't mean to. And I'm like, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. No, it's not okay. I have... come up. There we go. I haven't got enough head heights left otherwise to... Right, there we are. You're all right. Stick it back down. Don't panic now. There we go. course, because it says Swansea on there. There we go. Even though it's upside down, never mind. And then I'm thinking, I think that looks really cool. What do you reckon? It's just something a bit different, isn't it? I won't expect to see that. Like, really, when you open this flap up. And then perhaps that one there. And then perhaps that one there. There we go. Just to add a bit of interest. What do you reckon? I think that looks pretty cool. Hey, hey. I do have the odd rare occasion where I have a good idea. Even if I do say it to myself, I actually really like that. Right, okay, I'm very pleased with that. Let's just put these away. Bear with. Okay, so I'm just going to pop a hole in here for our closure. And then cut that down. Now, I have got, oh, isn't this beautiful? I have got some seam binding. I'm not sure if this will work, but we'll give it a go. Let's pop that through there. And then we'll have to come around the back. Need to make sure it's long enough. Oh, that's very pretty. Right, there we go. Yes, I think that's just the right closure for the front of that, because obviously we don't want to take away from the lace, do we? Right, okay, so there we are. Let's see if this will fit now inside of my mailed-to book. After me making the fuss about it being the wrong size and everything, or the other thing. With that look. Right, okay, so we're gonna have to open this up now. I hope I've got this right now. I haven't messed with it yet. No, I don't think I have. I think we should be okay. I'm gonna pop that through there. Ignore my messy. I haven't decided how to finish it off yet, so just ignore that for the moment. There we are. And then that, oh, that's the other important thing as well. That needs to go through there. Now, Rachel at Roxy Creations did put a nice little label or something on the back to keep hers in place. I may do that after when I decided what to do. In the meantime though, she did suggest you could use some washi tape to keep it in place. So I think I'm going to just quickly do that. Oh my word. Decisions. Let's put that one on there so I can see it. Don't you love it? Those little tasks that should like just take seconds to do. And then they don't end up taking seconds to do, if you can't find the end of the tape. I'm sure that's it there. Yeah, maybe not then. There we go. So let's just tape that down there. There we go. And then we will tie that closed. Oh, I'm so excited. There we are. So, as you open the journal, you should then have, oops, my tin, these sitting in place on the top here. Flip, flip, ta-da! Yes, you could put a pocket on the back of it, look, couldn't you? Oh, I think that looks lovely. Look how it goes with the material and everything. Marvellous! And then open it up. And then you can access the whole thing and even look inside of our harmonica pockets. There we go. You can get stuff in there, stuff in there. Oh, this is great because this is a real like secret hiding place now if you want to pop letters and stuff, because it just from the top looks like, and I love that, but it just from the top looks like a pocket, doesn't it? But actually, you've got secret pockets there and you've got a huge secret pocket. I've done this right. On the top of there too. So, you have something sticking out the top of there. Obviously, it wouldn't be very secret if it was sticking out, but that would be quite nice, actually, to have a tag in there. And maybe I can use some of my ruffle in the top, and that will just bring in... Oh, look at the colour, look. That was just perfect, wasn't it? Oh, I love it. And then again, you've got a lovely little tuck spot here then. Sorry, bringing the frame be good. Lovely little tuck spot here then to pop something, anything. What have I got to hand here? Nothing, as per usual. But let's pop that in there just so you can see. There we go. And I have a considerable size document sitting in there. And then, like I say, you've got pockets here. Gosh, that takes a really good size document there too. And then you've got another one here. And then obviously you've got your pocket here then to pop all your goodies in. Ah, marvellous. Right, okay. And I'm challenging you now, guys, to come up with something to put on your little inside flaps. I want to see you decorating those and showing me what you do with that. Because I think that just makes all the difference there. There we go, guys. That's it. That's your little trifold to go into our altered journal. If you are journaling along. If not, you've got a trifold there to go anyway. Courtesy of Rachel from Roxy's Creations. I believe it's week 16. That's quite scary saying that. My gosh. Into May next week, aren't we? May bank holiday on Monday. There we are. So that's today's project. I hope you have fun and I can't wait to see what you all make. See you all very soon. Take care now. Bye bye. Lost, demon car.